Urban planning is essential to local government capacity to effectively reduce the risk for disasters. It is regarded as the switchboard for implementing disaster risk reduction measures. Two cities that have addressed their urban planning challenges in sustainable ways are the cities of Malmö in Sweden and Copenhagen in Denmark. The city of Malmö used to be an industrial port city, but after the closure of some of its factories, particularly the Kockums shipyard, it had to rethink its reason for existence. Over a number of decades, parts of Malmö were transformed into the city of tomorrow, with the Øresund Bridge linking it directly to the city of Copenhagen in Denmark. Malmö University opening its doors in 1998, and its western harbour of Vesterhamnen becoming renowned for its environmental adaptation of a densely built urban environment aiming for sustainable living. Within a short space of time, Malmö University had refurbished a number of old factories and had constructed a number of new buildings which totally changed the face and the character of the city. In 2001, the European Trade Fair was hosted in the Western Harbour. Today, this is the flagship sustainable housing project in Malmö. Where a redundant industrial park used to be, a new ecologically sustainable area had now risen. This is a conurbation of mixed land uses with space for residential, education, retail, office and recreational uses that is so close to the city centre and reconnected to the beach and sea. The Western Harbour is a magnificent sight by its exposure to the sea, the open sky, the horizon, the sunset and the wind. The development is characterised by quality architecture and urban design. The architecture of the residential developments is diverse, intimate, and very pleasing to the eye. The distorted layout of the district is so designed to maximize the local environment's strengths, such as biodiversity, and minimize the local adverse climate impacts, such as wind. The layout and design also has safety and security in mind through a clear divide between private and public spaces. Public squares acting as random meeting places are strewn across the district. The sea promenade, Sandspromenaden, is lined with outdoor cafes, benches and a continuous wooden deck along the beachfront, ending in a sheltered harbour for small boats and yachts on one side and a lookout deck on the other. The Western Harbour is not only a magnificent place to live, but promotes sustainability through public and non-motorised transport, biodiversity, recycling and energy efficiency. During the construction phase, new technologies, material and construction methods were used to reduce the energy used for construction. Furthermore, all electricity is produced locally, and that from renewable energy sources such as wind, solar and water. Residents have access to their electricity meters to monitor and regulate their electricity usage. All refuse are recycled in recycle disposers that operate on a suction system. Organic waste is converted into biogas for heating and fuel. Sewage is treated and energy and nutritious substances are extracted to be reused. Malmö has an excellent public transportation system, consisting of trains and buses within the city, as well as connecting it to the wider region. Buses run on biogas and all maintenance and cleaning city council vehicles are electric. Pedestrian and cycling routes are prioritized to encourage active traveling. Residents also have access to carpools for the rare occasions they need private vehicles. Biodiversity was ensured by including numerous green spaces in the development of the district. Several small green parks can be found among the residential areas, as well as courtyards within each development. These green spaces contain diverse fauna and flora, with bird and frog boxes and large trees in each. Water canals and ponds collect rainwater and melted snow, home to different species of fish. Green roofs and facades are also encouraged, contributing to the microclimate and biodiversity. Dania Parken at the edge of the development is a huge open space where people can jog, play sports and games, and have a picnic with an open view to the sea. When sustainable measures are mainstreamed into development, the number of disaster risks is also reduced. For example, sufficient stormwater runoff is provided. It provides a healthy environment for people to live and work in, thereby reducing vulnerabilities. For example, by encouraging active traveling or the outdoor activities in quality open spaces. Overall, it contributes to the resilience of cities and its people.